the story of Job. One person once said, the story of Job, it's a microcosm of our story. What Job went through alone, we are going to go through as the people of God in the last days. Losing everything. And after he lost everything, Job, my Bible says, he bowed down and worshiped. I wonder how many of us will lose their job and still worship God. How many of us will lose their children? Not even their children, just one child. And worship God. You know, when I read, at times when I read the story of Job, I put hands in my pocket and ask myself questions. Will I manage to stand or to bow down and say, blessed be the name of the Lord, when there are 10? That is why. When you come to verse 1, the Bible says, there was a man Amen. In the land of Uz, yeah. whose name was Job. Wow, a classical writing. Then you ask yourself a question, what is it about this man? And then it says, he was perfect, upright, the one that feared God and shunned evil. And verse 2 says, and there were born unto him 7 sons and 3 daughters. As if it's enough, you come to verse 3. Verse 3 tells you of the wealth he had. Are we together? He had 7,000 sheep, 3,000 camels, 500 donkeys, and 500 yoke of oxen. Are we together? He had all this, and he was the he had a great household, and he was the greatest in the east. But all these deeds, the introduction, giving you what he has, children, 7 sons, 3 daughters, he had all this wealth. And when he had all these things are not what made him. But what made him is what he is, who he worshipped. Because who he worshipped is challenged because of his integrity to who he worshipped. Then the Bible will tell you that in verse 6, it says, the sons of God came before the Lord, and Satan was amongst them. You know, I picture this, my brother, in a boardroom situation in a meeting, and God the Father being the chairperson, sitting in the chair, and the sons of God are sitting around him. As they are sitting, there is another man in the midst of the sons of God. And God is not addressing all of them, but he picks him up and say, where do you come from? What? Didn't God know where this being came from? Was it not the same God who kicked him out of heaven? And he said, who unto you? So God knew the destination of this being that was kicked out. But question, why is God saying, where comest thou? And listen to the answer. The answer is giving us a clue as to why is God asking a question. He says, I come from the earth. I was walking to and fro and up and down. Wow. Science student, when you will say, and fro, they will quote Einstein's laws. They will say action, reaction. He says, I come from walking to and fro and up and down in it. In short, he's saying to God, the earth is mine. I'm in charge of the earth. Have you considered my servant Job? What is God saying to Satan? God says, instead of you coming here as a representative of planet Earth, there is a man in the land of Uz who qualifies to sit in the chair, not you. There is a man in the land of Uz whose name was Job. He's perfect. He's upright. The one who fears the Lord and shuns evil. Listen to this notorious being talking to a creator as if he's talking to his own peer. Does Job fear God for naught? Didn't you put a hedge around him? As Christians, we should be jumping when we read that part. That when you are sleeping at night, you do not know there's a hedge around you. When your neighbors are complaining that there are witches in this area, you are sleeping like a baby, a hedge around your house. You know, God operates in a way I don't understand. You know, God will protect you at night. He will not even come and tell you, my brother, I protected you last night. He remains quiet. And the book of Job is following what we call in science a sinusoidal wave. Up and down, up and down. Are we together? In verses 1 to 5, you're talking about the book of Job discussing things family below. You come to chapter 6, you remain lost when you are in the family below, for the chapter now is with the family above. Now in heaven, chapter 6, the discussion, the meeting is about to begin. As it is about to begin, God picks up that being and God says, and that God says, no. He does not worship me because I'm bribing him. He worships me for he knows I am his creator and I am his redeemer. He's mine to times. Then the devil said, no. Take everything he heard and you will see. He will kiss you in your face. And the Lord said, everything is in your hand. But his life, you dare touch it. And my Bible says, brothers and sisters, we are chapter 1 verse 6, we are in heaven. We are waiting for the meeting to begin. We are interested in the agenda of the meeting. But now, when we are looking, waiting to see the agenda, the minutes of the previous meeting and everything, the camera quickly moves from the family above to family below. And we remain wanting to know what's happening with the family above. We are now on planet Earth. And this notorious being, he came to attend a meeting, isn't it? But when God said to him, he's in your hands, he didn't even say goodbye in heaven. He just disappeared. I think he thought God is like him. He thought maybe God will change his mind. Then he wasted no time. He went. Wow. That being. When he came on earth, my Bible says, he's a strategist. He plans. When God's people don't plan, don't pray, don't organize themselves, our enemy is a player. When he comes to destroy you, you know what he does first? He prepares. When he came to Job, the first thing he did was to prepare the four messengers. And you know, when he looks for four messengers, he made a point that he wants people who are able to talk. People that, my brother, we can be together and see an accident, but the way I'll explain it, you will even wonder, did we see the same accident? The devil looked for such people. And Bible says, he started. Look at his plan, verse 13. He goes to the house of where the sons of Job are gathered. He looks and says, today is the day. Okay, they are here, all of them together. Good. He checked. Remember, the Bible only mentions the sons of Job and the three sisters. But no, the party was full. How do we pick it up with the message of the messenger? I'm the only one. But the only one was not mentioned in the beginning. Only the sons and the daughters. Are we together? So now, messenger number one says, the sheep, the oxen and the donkeys, the oxen were plowing and the donkeys were grazing beside them. And the sapiens came and took them away and they killed all the servants. I am the only one remaining. And the guy knows the purpose of him remaining. He says, I'm the only one remaining. So to bring the message. To bring the message as the messenger. Question. Who's sending this guy? Can I talk to a church? Do you know that this messenger, it's a representative sometime of some people in church? People who, when they are asked to do something in church, they will hide. They will not come to church. Are we together? When you ask them, but why don't you participate? They will tell you, oh, I am not an eloquent speaker. I cannot talk. The very same thing. Something happens in the church. They are the one to wake people at night. Have you heard? Have you heard? Have you heard? Ah, you are now able to speak. You are now an eloquent speaker. Be careful. Who's disciple you are? When God called his people to deliver the good news, there are other people ready to be bearers of the bad news. So messenger number one is not sent by God. God cannot work together with the devil. So this messenger is bearing the bad news. Look at the devil's plan. He wanted to take Job before he killed him. He wanted to throw him in a depression ward. So when the messenger comes and delivers the good news, Job is standing there. It's fine. I lost the donkeys. I lost my oxen. It's okay. Before he's done, my Bible says, while he was yet speaking, there came another messenger. And when this messenger comes, he says, the fire of God. Question. Where did this guy meet God? Where did they discuss him and God? The fire of God came from heaven and it devoured the sheep and they killed the servants with the edge of the sword. I am the only one remaining to deliver the bad news. Messenger number two, a very, very intelligent person to deliver the good news. And said, the fire of God came down from heaven. Messenger number three is bringing another message. The remaining wealth that you thought you have, it's gone. The fourth messenger comes to Job. While this one is still delivering the bad news, he says, please move. You're talking about the things, the substance. I'm talking about something important. He looks at Job. And when Job is receiving, you know, in sequence, the bad news, the greatest bad news was the fourth message. He says to him, your sons, your daughters were in the eldest brother's house and the wind from the wilderness came and struck the four corners of the house.